got home from work just a little bit early. He took his wife's car out to get the groceries. Then he pulled down his visor to hide a red sunset when a little scribbled note fell on his lap. Said, I've been cleaning up this fire out here at Bench Creek, and I know you probably shouldn't come out here to see me, but there's this beautiful spot right next to the shoot tree. Maybe we could find love for a while. Said, I know you probably shouldn't come out here to see me, but everything you do makes me smile. He could not get that letter off his mind. He took his truck up on the middle gate ridge line. His wife had said she was going out with friends when he saw headlights come around the bend. It was a truck that he had seen before at the taverns, in the ballpark, in the grocery store. A young man he'd had beers with many a winter's night. His mind reeled as his wife's car pulled into sight. He hammered his fist into the dusty ground. It was the night he cut the shoe tree down. On the night he cut the shoe tree down. If folks could feel the rumble for miles and miles around, then as it fell his heart broke, but no one heard the sound. On the night that he cut the shoe tree down. It's been a long, hard winter, a whole lot colder than before. The folks hardly seem to smile, and the kids don't talk no more. She finally found that scribbled note in the family gun safe, next to shotgun shells and an empty 410 case. She never kissed the young man, not once. They sat and laughed next to the shoot tree. They had good old-fashioned fun. Now she lost that picture, perfect house with the white picket fence, and no one in town seen her husband since. Sometimes hopes and dreams fall shattered like dead leaves on autumn ground, since the night he cut the shoe tree down. It was the night he cut the shoe tree down, down, down. Fell, his heart broke, but no one heard the sound. On the night he cut the shoe tree down. And some say he went into the mountaintops, but he has not been found since the night he cut the shoe tree down.